Hello and welcome to my first proper video in a long time. I've made a nether tunnel design that is both relatively cheap and can be used fast by foot, by horse, by minecart, by boat, and also somewhat by elytra. But it requires some skill. I have also packed this into a data pack so that the individual modules can be loaded. I will link that in the description. And yeah, the main focus of this video is to get feedback before I build it on the SliceLine fan server, and maybe some people find this useful and want to build this in their own world. So this is the basic module. I used stone bricks just because that is some arbitrary block with a high blast resistance against ghasts. For example, if someone has an elytra and flies on the side of the tunnel, the ghast cannot possibly shoot a hole into this. These gates, the trapped doors, are here for walking. Like this. This is pretty fast. The rails, obviously, for minecart. 10 blocks out is there's a 10 block distance between every powered rail. That is actually enough to get pretty much the maximum speed. Excuse me, I did a mispassing video on this. And for the boats, there is this blue ice. On the sides, you could actually also use blue ice, but that's more expensive. Slabs work just as well, or any other block that is lower than a regular block, because the boat doesn't touch it then. For horses, there's this airspace here, because otherwise you could suffocate in the ceiling. I could give myself a horse here. Ah, forgot the entities. There. Then you can see that I can't properly jump. Okay, here. I have my head inside this upper block here now. This could, in theory, if you want to give yourself more space for elytra, be expanded even higher, and then you have like a 3x3 or 3x4 or 3x5 space for flying. But you can, in theory, also fly through this. This is not that great for elytra, as you will see later as well, but it is certainly usable if you are very good at flying. I have used torches here just for lighting up. It isn't actually necessary because there are slabs and rails or anything else on every single block where monsters could in theory spawn, like Pikmin. So it is actually already completely spawn safe. And nether mobs they ignore the light level anyway, so this is just for decoration and optically lighting up. And it's for symmetry with the redstone torches here. Which could also be placed here if you don't want that. If you want, for example, a dark design, you can make it completely light level 0 and just place the torches below here. You could also replace these walls with anything else and then place the blast resistant block like stone bricks or cobblestone or whatever around this. And that way you can, on the inside, basically customize every single block except for the blue eyes, the rails, and the trapdoors. The trapdoors could in theory also be wooden trapdoors, but then you could, for example, if you fly with a elytra through here and you look slightly too far up, like this, you could accidentally open it while trying to use a firework, or just in any other situation where you could accidentally click, and then you would block the next person going through. Yeah, so this data pack, I called this Nether Tunnel, fittingly. And the default piece is just called tunnel. So you just load this in the default position and you have this standard piece. Then for the next piece, you always go where the powered rail is, so the last block, and place it below to the side like this. That's also why it contains air, so that you don't even have to do anything with this relative position. You just enter this. For the intersections, which I will explain later, it is actually sometimes required to change the relative position, but I will list that where necessary. Yeah, so this way you can just expand it if you just want to load it in with a data pack, but of course if you build it in survival you can make these arbitrarily spaced apart however you like. There's something here I wanted to discuss. If you go by boat, And there are slabs here on the side. You can go very fast. And if there are full blocks on the side, then this is much slower. You get some benefits from the ice compared to, for example, this, which is even slower, but not that much. So I guess I'll use the minecart now for going further. And probably, what is it? I don't know which volume is it. So the minecart part of is made for being hard AFK. Intersections always lead you to the farthest endpoint by default, or if you go back, always to spawn. And the intersections will give you opportunity to choose on the fly which direction you want to go. This is not programmed in at the station because that would be much more complicated and expensive to build. As I said, one of the target goals here was to make it a bit cheap. Here I have the parts called slope bottom, slope middle, and slope top. Slope top up there. These are pretty safe explanatory. I've used stairs here, which doesn't really matter much. The top here is also spawn safe, just for a bit of noise reduction. Of course, as if you build this in the middle of Netherrack, you would not use these slabs at all. But if you want them to disable spawns, that is entirely possible. So this is, does not have these trapdoors anymore, of course, because you wouldn't you would want to jump up here anyway, or use these stairs on the side, which is a bit faster. And bolts, of course, cannot go up here, because you would just drive against the wall. Yes, desynchronized bolts, nice. But if you want to go down, you can actually do this easily. Boat, come here, okay. The powered rails are spaced out 4 blocks here instead of 10, so that a regular person can go up this pretty much maximum speed still. And as you just saw a minute ago, an empty minecart might actually come back this direction, but I don't think that's a problem. Empty minecart shouldn't be on here anyway. Minecarts with chest would actually go through here if they have some items in them. And here I'm loading a standard piece again, so the trapdoors start again. And here I have a curve. This curve is made, for example, for boats. There are stones here, so that you can go around the corner easily, because turning on here is a bit messy, as you can see. Minecarts just drive around it like normal, no problem here. I've placed some extra torches here just for lighting, again, not really necessary. And also the boat cannot possibly go over this carpet, so that you don't end up in the stone region. But I have left some extra air room in here for the Elytra Flyer, so that they can use a more gradual curve. Have I missed anything? Oh yeah, running. You can just go over here or follow the regular route, it doesn't really matter. I've also left out these trapdoors here, because you can more easily see that something is going on. And this banner is just an example. That you can, for example, from far away already see that. This is helpful, for example, for especially for boat and Elytra users, which can then adjust to that with proper reaction time. And here I have actually loaded the regular piece with 90 degree rotation, because there was a curve here, and then curve back, that is also the rotating 90 degrees, because it's still, like, from the old curve, it's still rotated, and also flipped so that it goes into the other direction. This changes the arrangement of torches relative to that. I've asked around, and people say they usually place the torches on the left when going away from spawn, like in caving and stuff like that. But of course, if you flip the thing, then the torches are arranged differently again. There wasn't really a way to do that without having like every flipped structure it being its own structure. And of course, the banner is the wrong direction, so you would just craft the other banner. Then I have a slope downwards here. I have actually put a slope top and a slope bottom directly directly next to each other. This works as well. No problem here. And the coordinates are actually changed here because it's going downwards, so it's flipped here vertically or whatever that means. It's not really vertical. And then the coordinates are adjusted accordingly. Here it's 20 and minus 10, but it might also be different depending on which direction you load it in. And here 15 and minus 2, but again, it varies. Anything else to say about this? Probably not. So I'll continue. Here is another long piece before I come to the first intersection. Here you can, again with the boat, you just have some stone so that you can more easily get around the curve in a more controlled way. Running is no problem. Elytra, again, there's some space hollowed out here. Horses also have no problem. You can go through here or you can go through here. Doesn't really matter much. And for the minecarts, the default direction is towards. So if this is spawn, for example, if this is spawn, for example, then you would by default always go straight to the, which I assume to be the farthest location, because then you can basically, if you want to go to the farthest location, yes, then you can AFK in the minecart until you are there. And if you come back from here, then you automatically go towards spawn. If you don't do anything, as you can see here, the detector rail triggers some circuitry, which I will explain later, and that changes this curve. This curve rail. Again, if you come from here, then the curve changes as well, and you go towards spawn by default. If you don't want to go to the default direction, you can open these trapped chests. As you can see there on the right, the rail changes if you do this. If you do it here, then nothing happens because you would choose, like the trap chest is on the left, so you choose to go to the left, but it would go to the left anyway, so opening the trap chest doesn't do anything. But if you go over here with the minecart, of course the rail changes, and opening this the trap chest, as you can see there, undoes that. Same with this trap chest. So that you then go towards this direction again, and here towards this direction, because you've clicked the right chest, so you go to the right. Circuitry is actually pretty compact. I wanted it to that way so that Elytra flyers can go through here without much problem. So it's actually all hidden in the ceiling. Well, the wiring that connects to this is to connect to the ceiling. The wiring in the edges is actually so simple that it doesn't need to be hidden. This redstone torch is just for powering the power array. You could also move these further away if you wanted, for example. They could get rid of this block, for example, which only holds a torch anyway. And you could change a lot of things, but this wiring is what I found to be working the best. So this detector rail powers this redstone, which deactivates this torch, which activates this torch, and goes through here, and switches away. Same with the other detector rail. So, if you come from any of these two directions, the rail switches and leads you to there. But if you then open the... where is it? Minecart, please. Okay. If you then open this trap door, then this deactivated redstone torch doesn't matter anymore because this repeater deactivates this redstone torch. So the redstone line deactivates again, switching the rail back. The same happens here. Just rotate. Or not goodbye because I forgot a lot of things. Especially game audio was missing in the until now. I had something badly configured in OBS. I have now, as I said, updated the slope structure. So now I reset this as well. So you can now properly ride it upwards. I spaced these out 3 blocks now instead of the 4 that I said in the video. And X-ray. And that you get pretty slow this way, but no matter how high it is, you can always go the full distance up. I also updated the I also updated the stations, which I will show in a moment. Where are they? Stations. Here. Okay, this is a station I updated. Now this is a dropper. And the rails should hopefully be saved correctly in the structure file now. And if not, I showed how to replace them correctly. Also, I considered whether I should make a proper tutorial for the building this, but it's basically just place blocks, ice, rails, and trapdoors. That's not that hard. The trickiest part is actually placing these rails correctly, but I showed that in the video, and on the intersections how to wire everything, but I showed that as well in the structure file, so you can just download it. I don't think a block-by-block tutorial would help much here. And what I also forgot is... yeah, I kept calling the station circuit at some point in the video, I don't know why. And yeah, if you rotate the... Oh, this is actually wrong. Like this, okay. Save. If you rotate this, it can actually get a bit messed up. For example, let's say 180 degrees. Then the rail is also wrong, and there's not really a way to place this correctly. Because, as I will show here, no. Okay, like this. It's supposed to be like this, but if you then just happen to randomly power it and then depower it again, it will always switch to this again. So either you can make absolutely sure that never anything powers this at all, which might get difficult, or you just place a lever on top of it, for example, with and some block above it that holds it. There can be a slab, or actually it can also be a carpet. It's the minimum block that obstructs your gliding space for Elytra the least. And it's actually a bit tricky to place it. You need a vine for this. And you do that... Oh, wrong block, doesn't matter. By placing the carpet here on top. Wait, no, that's not what I wanted. Place the carpet on the side of a block here, and then you can place the lever below it like that. And then you can remove this again. That way, basically, you have carpet and lever suspending each other, and you can activate it, power it correctly. Or alternatively, you just place it in the way you want it, and make sure that absolutely never ever powers it. And yeah, this gets a bit in the way if you jump like this, but this is a safer method, basically. And I should really close this. Okay, I need to cut the video anyway. I also forgot that I have undo structures for everything. For example, if I now place the intersection 2 and I place it like it's a completely wrong place and like this, and now I have loaded it in there and totally didn't want to do that, then I can just append underscore undo to it, load, and for other intersections it's actually like this, and then load that and it disappears. For everything else it's just like for example curve undo is like this, and thumbnail undo is like this. It's just aired so that you can undo an arbitrary mistake. When I said that you can basically do anything with decorating this, it was not quite specific, because for the bolts, if you drive on the wall onto the wall here, you can see that I'm still the bolt is still on the ice. That is important. And go away. So the tunnel should only be 3 blocks wide. In theory, it could be like 3.5 or something like that, but there is actually no block that does that. So it needs to be a 3 wide tunnel, at least for these blocks here, no matter what you decorate. Then the outermost block doesn't need to be stone bricks, of course. You can also use cobblestone or anything else. Here is a full list of things you can use. That is basically all the double slabs except for the wooden ones. So stone brick, double slabs, or prismarine, or whatever, and all the regular variants of all of those as well. Also purple pillars, which apparently have no slabs, interesting. The ore-related blocks, obsidian, iron bars also work, and it's the only non-full block I've listed here. There are also some others, like for example nether brick fences can also be used, but I didn't want to list that because I think there's a possibility in some arrangements that you can be shot by a skeleton through these. I just wanted to make sure. So you can look up blast resistance on the Minecraft Wiki to get the full list of blocks. If they have blast resistance 30 or more, you can use them. But of course make sure that there's no gaps and stuff like that. You can also use jukeboxes if you want to go really crazy, or you can even build your tunnel out of shulker boxes, but I don't think anyone would do that. If you want to load the curves, let's load a regular piece here, and now I load a curve but flipped so that it goes to the left. Then loading it in normally does not work, it is not connected to this. The offset you need for that is actually the same as for the flipped intersections. So for example here I'm looking at east direction and I want the curve to also go north. Then I look at east north, so I need an offset of 0.16. Do that, load, and it connects properly. And of course because it's flipped banner as well. Then for the intersections I experimented a bit again with node blocks. Where did I do that? Oh, here. So I experimented with node blocks. Ignore the circuitry up here. You can actually place node blocks on the side here and just use an observer below it, and then you can put the entire circuitry below. This redstone dust here will be activated by that node block. And of course if you don't want the sound you can just do this. But the redstone still lights up. And detector rail similarly can light up this redstone here. And a redstone torch that is placed on this location can actually power this rail. So if there's any interest in a proper circuit that is where basically only the node block and the observer is visible and nothing else, I could build that as well. But for now, maybe I will stick to the trap chest, or maybe not. Maybe comment write a comment what you would prefer, what design you like more. And yeah, this node block, for example, is mainly for this direction. Actually, no, it's not. It's for this direction, so you can go left by clicking this. But if you click it like here for going right, there's actually no harm in that. It doesn't actually doesn't interfere with the rail at all. It's if I had actually placed and built the circuit here. Because the default direction is actually wrong. Okay, no. Usually you would need the other intersection design here. So here would be a powered rail and you would go there by default, and if you click this, then you would go right. And then there would be no detector rail here, and you would go left anyway, but if you click it to go left, there's no harm in that. And if you click it like here to go right, then it would work. So even if this basically would, from this side, you would have a node block on the left and on the right, but it doesn't matter if you click the one you don't need to click, it still works. Hopefully that was somewhat understandable. And I also wanted to show properly again how to load these structures. I said already that you can place them like at the bottom left, below the bottom left, below to the side of the bottom left block here. And then the coordinates will already work, except that this one is rotated. And if you, for example, want to place a slope, a bottom slope of the slope, this works as well. And then the next one is also below and to the side of the bottom left block, like this. This is actually the same distance from. No, it's even more distance from the ice, one block more, but it's like below and to the left of this stair block again. So, nether tunnel, slope, middle, load this, and it connects properly. The same can be done for the top slope and for all the curves and intersections. As you can see here, I did it here as well from the intersection part. It will always work out like that in the default. Actually, in all rotations, but if you don't flip. If you flip it, again, you need these offsets, which you also need for the offset curves, for the flipped curves. And these offsets are then the exact same as for the flipped intersections. I also didn't tell you how to use the data pack. It's actually pretty easy. You can just go to your Minecraft folder, which by default on Windows you can get to by entering this. And on Linux it's usually this one. And on Mac I actually don't know, but Googling it usually works. For me it's in my Google Drive folder, and I have a Minecraft folder in there. There will be a folder called Saves, and in there there are your creatively named worlds. Select the right one you want, and there's either is a folder named datapack, or you need to create the folder named datapack. In there you just drop in the zip file just like that. It will work. What it contains is actually just a little description which is used for this. And I think I didn't enter any description. Yeah, I didn't enter any description. And then there are the structures in here. Awesome. Yeah, that should be about it. Now I'm actually done. And again, I would like some feedback. And I hope you enjoyed the video. And goodbye.